Welcome back. In this video, I'll explain how to process your data so that you can get the answer to your research question. This is the table we made last time. And as you can see from the title of the table, we are looking at the effect of mass of sugar on the volume of CO2 produced. You could add even more data, probably would in your table, in the title of your lab. For example, effect of mass of sugar on the volume of CO2 produced by yeast in anaerobic respiration over 20 minutes, something like that. That said, you're always going to want to take an average of your trials and the standard deviation of your trials. As such, this should always go in the same column, average and standard deviation. Now, let's actually make this a little bit wider, and clicking here on wrap text, we'll get it in one line. And just again, for visual neatness, adding these, and let's make this column look a little bit different to make it stand out from our raw data. Do something a little like this. As you can see, I like colors. So, to figure out the average and standard deviation, by the way, I'm centering everything once again, all you have to do is let Excel do the math for you. Whenever you want to do an equation in Excel, you can just do equals and then the equation you want. So in this case, we want the average. You then have to open brackets, and now you will highlight the data you want. So, any guesses what the average of these 5 trials are? Well done, it's 0. So, now that this is done, Excel will do all the hard lifting for you. If you remember that drag and drop technique, you move the cross to the corner until it turns into a black cross, click, and then drag it across. And Excel is smart enough to figure out how to do that. So, here's the average of these data, here's the average of these, etc., etc. Now, standard deviation is just as easy. Equals, and you have to do ST for standard, DEV for deviation. Open your brackets, and highlight it straight through. And that's done. Then, again, move your mouse till the black cross, pull it across, and let's make it neat. Let's give everything the same number of decimal places. As a rule, your processed data should have one more decimal place than your raw data. So all of this has one decimal place, all of this has two. Now, this is what you will graph. You will graph only your processed data, though I will show you how to do that in another video. For now, your data processing, at least the basics, are done. What you can see is a steady increase in the amount, the volume of carbon dioxide produced. And here, you can see the spread of the data. So here, because all the data were identical, there's a spread of 0. Whereas here, it's 6.8 with a standard deviation, an average difference, kind of about 0.36, 0.44, 0.22, 0.67, and 0.31. What this means is that this one, 0.67, is the highest standard deviation, so this data here is the least accurate. It had the widest difference in my raw data. This one would be the most accurate. And that's something that's nice to talk about in your evaluation, especially if the standard deviation is bigger than your average. That means you can't trust your data at all. Now, let's go to the other table, the one where you had initial and final, and talk about how to do that. Now, first off, you're going to want to make a process data table which shows the difference. And then we can figure out the average difference. So let me copy this one just for the outline. And we'll use this as the backbone. So I'm going to delete all the contents. And I'm changing the title for the effect of mass of sugar on the change in volume. So here, you're going to want to, again, use an equation. Use equals final minus initial. Enter. And I'm going to pull it down. Here, we'll do it again. Equals final minus initial. Enter. Equals final minus initial. And you do this for each of your columns. Once we've done this, we're going to use the drag technique to have it, to have Excel figure this all out for us. So, drag it down, drag it down, drag it down. And what's nice about this is now processed data, so you've done math to it, but it's simpler. We can then also do the average and the standard deviation, like last time. So, pull across, and pull across. Perfect. So, here is our processed data table of this data. So, let's focus in on that processed data table for a sec. Obviously, 13.52 is bigger than 0. So if I look at my averages, they seem to increase across. But how could you prove that? The easy way of doing it would be a t-test. A t-test is perfect for comparing two sets of raw data. Note that I said raw data. So this will allow us to compare our data from 0 to our data here, which even on first glance seems to be different. So let's look how to do this. Thank you to Excel equals t-test. Open brackets, select your first data, comma, select your second set of raw data, not the averages, comma, and then you just want to do 1, 1. Don't worry too much about that. Close brackets and enter, and it's done. Now, this data, this is a very, very small number. This is 7 times 10 to the negative 14. So it's 0.1307. Generally speaking, what this means is that this would be significant. Anything less than 0.05, less than 0.05 means there is a statistical difference. It means your data actually suggests a difference. So let's try two sets that are much more, much closer. So here was our 0 versus 5 grams of sugar. Let's try 4 versus 5. So equals t-test. Let's highlight the raw data for 4, comma, highlight the raw data for 5. Oh, and 1, 1. So that's 0.052. So that's bigger than 0.05. So it suggests there is no statistically significant difference. What this number actually means is this is the percentage chance that they are different. The same. Anything less than a 5% chance of being the same, we're now confident enough that they are different. So I could obviously continue this, doing 0, first 2, etc. But that would take forever. So how would I do all of them to see if there's a difference in all my data? And the trick for that is an ANOVA test. An ANOVA test compares multiple sets of raw data. So let me show you how to do this. On my statistics website, there is a section, biology, internal assessment, statistics. There is a section on the ANOVA test. Click on this link to get this bar right here. Now, how many groups do we have? Well, we have 5 columns of data. So that's 5 groups. Submit. Now I just need to copy and paste the data. And what's wonderful is you can copy it straight from anything. From Excel, from numbers, from spreadsheets, etc. So I'm copying my raw data. Note that I am not including... Oh, I actually had 6. I'm not including my averages. So let's try that again. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now what this is going to do is it's going to again give me a number. When I click calculate now, the number I care about is the p value. Now, let's look here. The probability of this result is less than 0.0001. Again, anything less than 0.05 means there is a difference in the data. It means that this data is not the same as this one. So, this is smaller than 0.05, so there is a difference. In the conclusion of your lab, you can now say that your data suggests a statistically significant difference. Or, let's be even more clear, a statistically significant effect of mass of sugar on the volume of CO2. So you have answered your research question. Okay, that's data processing. And if you do the average, the standard deviation, and an ANOVA test or a t-test, this is great for comparing men versus women, older versus younger, maybe even colors. The ANOVA, great for comparing when you have multiple sets. By doing the average, the standard deviation, and a statistical test, you will have done more than enough math for IPBio. Okay, don't forget to cite whatever you use, especially this website, and check in on the next video on how to make a graph. Ciao!